think I'll do this particular drawing in my sketchbook so that I know, so they don't get confused with my other drawings. And we'll start with I want this creature to be rather ugly. Eyes then. The expression of the eyes is going to be so important. It's a sort of soft, fishy mouth, really. Teeth, yes. The really playing around with these shapes. Go back to the drawing. Again, that's nice because we see the back. Don't want to see her face at all. Yeah, that's working, that's starting to work. This is the prow of the ship then. Coming forward. This is the rails. And it goes out of the picture here. There's the rails on the other side. Behind the stage a little bit further, and of course we'd have the anchor. We have the anchor on there, on the drawing of the, so I could be like that. I'm going to sit back from it. It's starting to go, it's starting to work. More water coming up. Waves in there. Going down into a trough, another wave here. Really churning the water up. We could have a little bit of a back river, but we'd have to have the masts. Don't want to do that too much. Why do we have the masts? Let's have a quick look at where the masts were. This is where the drawings. The mast comes from the centre and from the right. Okay, so we could have a mast. The mast would be around about there. That's better. We're getting more fishlight. They can stand forward. Rather be recessed, and oh, that's nice. I don't need to smile, I'm looking a bit too happy, this creature. Let's between fish, snake and lobster, this creature. And a little bit of sea slug thrown in for good measure. I think I said it was scaled too, so we have to work a bit of scaling into this too. So here we're starting to see underneath the creature. This is the let's just shake this. Give it some volume. There. This is the underbelly of the creature. So this is where we could have our scales. I see this as being a little bit more yellow underneath now. Slightly green on top, yellow-green. So slightly different colour for the top of the bottom of the creature. And in the background now we've got the loop of the creature going away from us there, and another loop there. Oh, that filled in the space rather nicely, so we're going to be seeing that loop going through there. So there's a real sinewy feel to this. And perhaps it's going away from us again. Like that. Behind the mast. Maybe churning up the sea through there. So we'll have water there. I'll correct this drawing that I've got of the galleon. It's really getting the angles right at this stage and the positioning. That's better. And that means that this mane comes down here. Now the creature is supposed to be also have some vestiges of arms and legs. Certainly more alien than we've had before. Now, both sides of the face are different here. Let's take that straight down. That's the top jaw, that's the bottom. It's interesting how just a few changes of line can change the nature of an expression of a person or a creature. And bottom lip there. Also it's an open jaw. Strengthen those teeth. That's rather nasty. Looking too human now. Different thought altogether. What would happen if we give it a slit that way for? Slit. Okay, on the slit we'll be looking down. Looks like it's asleep. Wow. Larger. Certainly more unpleasant than the one we had before. Let's just darken this up a little bit with a graphite stick. Separate it from the rest of the head, show that it goes into interior. So that. Cut around like so. Mm-hmm. I'm happy to use an eraser to, as a drawing tool, changing all the time, keeping my options open. Well, that's nice and unpleasant. Yes, that's working. I like that head now. This going down then. This being the undercarriage, as it were. That's the scales on top. Fits in with Chinese dragons, fits in with sea serpents. Oh, this is working well now. It's starting to come together. There's a point at which the struggle becomes a pleasure as it starts to work again. No drawing like this works from the off. You have to really work at it to get it to come together. That's a solid loop in the background there. Going into the sea at that point. It's going to all be churning water. And then this is the tail. And I think we can continue that skirt of fin to around about there. Another sort of like the wings at the top, and then coming out into this tail. I think it should be that way around, like a whale, but slightly more spiny, slightly more open than I had it before, I think, slightly wider. We'll have a little more irregular than we had before. And this ends in a more stubby way, really. And these can be thicker. And this, that's fine. Coming into the sea there. This is going to be the, I would correct that mask, that's fine for the drawing, I know where it is, basically. In fact, it might come a little higher, it might come to there. We'll see what we can accommodate on the drawing. That to me now, that's more like a sea serpent. We've got those wonderful coils, we've got the claws. And it's much, much better compositionally now. Fizz looks a little bit, looks a lot smaller, more in peril, but she's standing there undaunted, and that, I think, will work. So, we can now move on to the next drawing. So,
Yes.